I apologize. I went too long tonight. Lord Jesus, tonight, if anybody's done any territorial spiritual warfare and they've been attacked in their body, their families, their finances, their career, something bad happened to them or their family, the demons and the heavenlies, whoever they are, the angels, whatever it is, they attack them, and they need to be restored. They're going to get special prayer tonight. Now, stand up and come down here. If you used to do spiritual territorial warfare at your church, and you got in trouble, come stand down here. That was a bad mistake. But it was not a malicious mistake. You are not a bad person. You are not a rotten person. You're not a idiot. You're not a moron. You were following maybe somebody else's lead. Somebody you respected told you you could do territorial warfare and wipe out the demons in your neighborhood. They didn't understand how that works. They made a mistake. They got attacked too. Okay, so you're not a bad person if you did that. Okay, you're going to come down here now, and we're going to break this curse off of you. We're going to break that curse off of you in Jesus' mighty name. After you repent, it's going to come right off of you. In the name of the Lord. If you went to a charismatic, prophetic, or Pentecostal church, and somebody with spirits put their hands on you, Paul told Timothy not to do that stuff. If somebody put their hands on you, and ever since they prayed with you that day, you felt a little off, a little odd. Something weird happened to you or your family. Please come down here. We're going to pray for you today. If somebody put their hands on you in a charismatic church, you never let that happen, because you don't know where these people have been. You don't know their character. You don't know if they have faith and a good conscience. You don't know who these people are. If you've ever gone through a fire tunnel, a prayer tunnel, anything like that, if you've ever been in a church where gold dust fell on the floor or a glory cloud flumped through the window, anything like that at all, and then after that you felt just a little odd or a little off later on, those are familiar spirits doing that. We're going to pray for you tonight. We're going to pray for you. Ministry team, go ahead and come on up. Thank you for helping. Our ministry team here is fantastic. They pray their guts up for people. So grateful for them. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, dear Lord. Okay, thirdly, if you tried to bind demons in someone, spouse, parents, kids, who wanted to keep their demons, and you, somebody told you you can just bind spirits and that's the end of it, and that person will shape up and fly right, if you ever did that, and they got worse, okay, I want you to come down and repent of it. You cannot do that. You cannot proclamate, I command my husband's demons to stop watching porn in the name of Jesus. Well, I command stop. I command my wife to stop shopping. I want that demon out of there. I command, that's not going to work. You cannot do that. If somebody wants to keep their spirits, you cannot bind them. You can bind them if they attack you. And that's a different story. Paul taught us that. Anybody do that? Come up for prayer. Okay? Anybody at all? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Anybody need special prayer tonight? Anybody need special prayer? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Okay. How many is that? Can you count those up for me? How many was it? Four. Special prayer. Anybody who's not up here, you need special prayer, just yell out what it is. What do you need prayer for? What is it? Ear healing. Anybody else? Brain concussion. From trauma?
Yeah, I
you fall?
I was distracted.
Okay. All right. Anybody else? Something wrong with your foot? What happened to it? Which foot is it? The right foot? Is your toes or your foot? You didn't hit it or anything? No, it just started hurting. Oh, it's okay. All right, good. Are you ready? Yeah. What do you want? Got neurological tremors. Okay, those are usually spirits. Is that from what? What caused that?
Probably spiritual warfare.
You did spiritual warfare? You gonna repent of it?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Close your eyes. Here we go. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. A low back? Okay. Close your eyes. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, we've got to straighten this out with you. We got to make this right. All right. And I pray now that you'll give each one of my friends a repentant heart right now. I ask you to forgive them for doing territorial warfare. I ask you to forgive them for trying to bind demons and people who want to keep their demons. I ask you, Lord, to forgive them. I want you to break this curse off of them. Whatever that curse is, physical, emotional, spiritual, whatever it is, dear Lord, I want you to break this curse off of them in the name of Jesus. Lord God, forgive me. Come on, just pray it out. Father God, forgive me. I'm so sorry for what I did. I humble myself to you, Lord. Right now, I humble myself in the name of Jesus. I bow myself in your presence, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I bow myself, Lord. Have mercy on me. God, forgive me. Forgive me, dear Lord. I receive my healing tonight. I receive my healing tonight, Lord. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Yes, sir. In the name of Jesus, right now. Right this second. And I command you, every territorial spirit, every spirit that attacked me or my family, every spirit that attacked me or my family, I command you to come out of me right this second. I command you this demonic concussion come out of my head right this second. You spirit of infirmity, I command you to loose my low back right now. I command you to come out. You foul spirit of infirmity, I command you, let go of my foot right this second. Right this second, Lord. I command you to come out of my foot right this second. Now in Jesus' name. Keep coughing. Come on out. There they come. They're coming out now. There they go. They're coming out right now. There they go. They're coming out now. Thank you, Jesus. Come out right now. Come out right. Come out right now. Come out of me right now. You territorial spirit. I bind your power and I command you. I repent of what I did. I repent of it right now in the name of the Lord. Come on out. Come out of there. Come out of there right now. Come out in Jesus' name. Keep coughing. Come out. Hold that. Come out right now. Hold that. Come out. Come out of there. Come out right now. Let's go. Come out right now. Let's go. Get out of that body. Get out of my body. Come out of my body right now. Where's the pain at? Right there? How long has that been hurting? 2 months?
Years.
Did you hurt it or something? Bending or something?
Then I started working on
sitting down. Started hurting. Oh, is it L4-5? Right here? Right down here? Oh, down in a lower area? Okay, ready? Thank you, Jesus. Father God, I ask you to touch in the name of the Lord and heal. And heal. spirit of infirmity, come out of her stomach right now. Take a breath and blow. Come out of there right now. Come on out. Come out of her. Stop attacking her body and come out right now. Stop attacking her body. Come out right now. Come out of that body right this second. Hurry up. Come out of there right now. And heal. Heal in Jesus' holy name. Come out of that body right now. Spirit, I command you in the name of Jesus. Come out of that body right now. God, there he is right there. Come on out. Come on up. Come on out right now. Keep. They're coming out now. There they go. Check out your bottom right now. Any change? Come out of there right now. Check it out. Come out of that body right now. Come out right now. Come out right now. Hurry up. Come out right now. Thank you, Jesus. Now hold that. Come out of there right now. Spirit, come out of that body right now. Come out of there, you demon of lust. Come out right now. The demon of anger. Come out right now. Come out of that body right now. Quickly. Quickly, come out. Quickly. Quickly, come out now. Get out of that body quickly. Come out quickly. Come out quickly. What's wrong with you, sweetheart? Come out of there quickly.
I'm not really sure. I may have done some of those prayers over our city and over.
You got any symptoms?
Well, I had breast cancer.
Come out of there right now. You got a demon of cancer in there?
I don't know.
How'd you get it?
Supposedly was taken care of.
Come out.
I don't know. There was a lump, and they did a lumpectomy and radiation. Come out. My breast. Really sore and hurt, and then they took the lymph nodes out, I've had kind of nerve damage, but then I don't know, I was having pain lately under this arm.
Come out.
I didn't know if it was coming back. I have fear.
Yeah, come out right now.
And I used to be doing like subconscious and that kind of stuff.
Come out of there. All right, you're going to keep getting sicker, okay? You got to repent of this right now. You're going to keep getting sicker if you don't repent. You repent of unbelief and doubt. Lord Jesus, please forgive me. Come out of there, devil. Get out of my body right now. Come out of that body right this second. Hurry up. Come out of there right now. Come out of there. Come out of there. Come out of there.
Hey.
What happened? What happened?
What happened?
Why'd you stop?
I just moved over here because it was really distracting.
Why'd you stop?
I'm not wanting to stop.
Okay, go. Ready? Come on out. There they go. Keep coming. Don't let her stop again. Come out of there. Now go. She repent of it. She repent of it. Come out of there. Lord Jesus, I don't really believe. And I got fear spirits and it's blocking my healing. You get out of there, you pervert. Come out of that body right now. Chronic disappointments. All the people that abandoned me, I forgive them. Go. Demon of fear, go. I repent of fear, doubt, and unbelief. I turn my back on it. I turn my back on it right now in the name of the Lord. I repent of it right this second. Fear, doubt, and unbelief. I want you out of my soul. Come out of my soul right now. Doubting the word of God, not believing. Come out, devil. Come out of there quickly. Come out quickly. Doubting God's word. I repent of it. Doubting I'm going to be delivered. Doubting I can't be healed. Come out of there. You get out of that body right now. Come out of his throat. Quickly. Come out of there. Come out right now. Big one. Big yawn. Come out. Next. Big yawn. Come on. Come out. Spirit, come out. I repent of this doubt and unbelief now. I drive it from my soul in the name of Jesus. I drive it from my soul right now in the name of Jesus. Get out right this second. Get out of there. Get out of there. You get out of my body right this second. You get out of my body right now. Come out. Keep coughing. Come out of that body right now. Quickly. Quickly come out. Quickly come out. I repent of it in the name of Jesus. You stole my healing. You're trying to kill me with cancer. I'm not going to take it anymore. I've had it up to here. I've had it up to here. I hate you. Come out of my body right now. I hate you. Come out, you spirit of fear. Go. Come out right now. I hate you. Come out of that body right now. There they go. Big yawn. Big yawn. There you go. Big yawn. Come out, devil. Come out of there. Satan, loose the man of God. Satan, loose him. Get out of my body right now. I told you to go. Get out of my body right now. I told you to go. Come on, sweetheart, fight. Come on, sweetheart, fight. You are not weak, and you do believe. You do have faith. Fight back now. Come on. You're not supposed to be stopping. You're supposed to continue on. Don't you dare stop. There it is. Here it goes. Come on now. Quicker. Don't you stop. Don't you stop. Don't you stop. Come out. Come on there. Keep coughing. Come out right now. Keep coughing. Come out. You get out. You get out of that body right now. Come out of my tummy. Come out of my stomach right there. Come out right now. Come out of my stomach. Let's go. Come on my tummy right now. Let's go. You cannot pray about demons. Praying does not work with demons. Don't pray over demons. You command them to come out. You don't pray over them. You pray before. You pray before. You cast out demons. You do not pray over demons. Just fight back quickly. Just fight back quickly. Come on now. Stop praying and fight. Stop praying and fight. Let's go. Push it. Push it. Don't sit there and do nothing. You got to step out on your faith. You got to do something to be healed. You got to step out on your faith. You got to push it. You got. You stopped again. What are you doing?
Get distracted.
Yeah. Put your hand over your ears. There you go. Come out, devil. Come on out. Take her over here. Take her over here. Go over there. Yeah, go over here. There you go. Yeah, face the wall. Atta girl. Now, no more distractions. Come out, devil. Come out. Come out of my body right now. You get out of my stomach. Come out. Come out right now. Quickly. Go. There he is. Keep going. Come on. Come on. Come on. I want you to yell at him. Get out. Go ahead. Atta girl. Scream it. Scream it out. Come on. Scream it out. Come on. Fight. These signs shall follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. Okay, do it right now. Tell that porn demon to come out. Come out of here, you pervert. You stinking pervert. Stealing my ministry. Come out of there. Sin. Trespasses. Anger. Lying. Cheating. Just repent of it. Go ahead and yell at him. Get out. And I go, come out. You can't get anything from God if you won't fight. You can't get anything from God if you won't fight. Sitting around ever learning but never coming to the knowledge of the truth doesn't work. Come on now, you got to push this thing. Come on now, you've been called by God to be a warrior. Timothy, I want you to war a good warfare. You got to fight back. You got to fight. Let's go. Fight back. Fight back. I come against you, you foul spirit. Of infirmity, of lust, of anger, of taking offenses. Come on now. Come out. Come out quickly. Taking offenses. You come out of there right now. Come out of there, you coward. Come out, you coward. Get out of that body right now. Stop distracting her. Come on, you got to push this thing. You can't just sit there and look around. Come on, fight. Satan, I command you to loose your hold. That's what Paul said. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of her. The demon came out in that very hour. Satan, come out now. Get out. Come out of there, you coward. You coward. Yell louder. Louder. Atta girl. Louder. Come out of there. Go. Atta girl. Come out. Come out. Fight as hard as you can. Quickly. Fight as hard as you can. Lord Jesus, by the authority invested in me by God's word, by the authority I exercise my authority and command every evil thing to come out of me, every lie to come out of me, every false belief come out of me. Come out, you stinking devil. Come on, you coward. You're a coward if you won't fight. That's a coward spirit. God has not given you the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. The word fear means coward in that verse. Cowardice. Dalia, it's cowardice. God did not give you the spirit of a coward. Are you on drugs? Are you on drugs? You will eventually die. You will die early. You will die ugly if you are on drugs. Drugs draws in spirits. Drugs draws in demons. Oxycodone, hydrocodone, Valium, fentanyl. If you're on drugs, you are going to die. You will die early. You will die ugly. Repent of it tonight and come down and get that pharmakia devil out of you. Medications, pot. If you're smoking pot, you will lose your mind. If you're smoking pot, you have very little time left. The demons will take your mind. But Brother Mike, I smoke pot because I use it for pain. The demons are using you for a pincushion. You fool. You fool. The demons come into your brain. 1, 2, 3, 4. Using pot. You smoking pot. You're in deep trouble. Deep trouble. People are getting schizophrenia from pot. They're getting psychoses from pot. They're coming down with mental illnesses. America is now on pot. Smoking weed makes you sick. Smoking weed gives you demons. Come down and repent quickly. Did you sleep with someone who had demons? Did you have sex with somebody who had demons? If you did, you picked up a transfer spirit. You picked up a transfer spirit. Now you're sick. They were sick. Now you're sick. They had demons. Now you got them. You sleep with somebody with demons and you can pick. Oh, good. Oh, good.
I mean, and I've been breaking soul ties, but, you know, I don't
that's
know.
Good. Well, you got it figured out perfectly. You figured it out perfectly. You did the right thing. You missed step three. No, that's because you missed step three. You missed step three. You did step one and two and did a good job. You said you repented, and then you said you broke soul ties. Perfect. Now you. Well, you don't need to, but now you got to get them out of there. They're in your body. No, of course they don't want to come out. They want you in bondage. They hate your guts.
My daughter, mine, like she smokes pot all the time.
No, you can't bind her spirit. She likes her demons. Smokes pot all the time.
You know, worse. Like when our son was on drugs and everything, I may have done that.
Just repent of it. But right now, you got to get these out of there. You got fear demons. You got fear demons.
Stomach aches in third grade.
That's fear demons.
And they took me and had all these tests. And anyway, they never figured it out. And later,
no, there's nothing wrong with you.
Anxiety,
well, that's a fear demon.
I was in Arizona in November. And I started, you know, we get lights down here a lot and stuff. And I didn't think too much of it. Then I kind of got light on my body. Then I got here. Then I went home and I had, like, I call it welts.
They're spirits.
And so I've been getting a lot of things that I had all.
Yeah, they're in your body.
Every time, like, I get a cat scratch me, and I hear that that could be really bad on your arm. So I went to the doctor, and, you know, that I always think I've got something.
Those fear demons.
And I remember my mom saying that this friend of mine, when I was about 12, had, she died of cancer. And I said, well, I didn't even know she smoked. And she kind of laughed at me, like, you're so dumb. And she goes, there's lots of different ways to get cancer.
Yeah.
And it was like, I go, well, how do you wouldn't even know if it's in your body? And I don't know. I just.
No, yeah, you know.
Little, I've been hesitant. And,
no, those are fear demons. You got fear demons. You know what they are. They're fear demons.
I guess I don't know how to get out. And then I keep thinking, because we enjoy having a glass of wine. And then I think I'm going to go to
that doesn't have anything to do with it. Wine, having a glass of wine means nothing. No, you got fear demons. They're in your body. If they don't come out of your body, you're done. No, screaming at them doesn't do any good. No, you have to believe in your heart. Truly believe without doubting that you have the authority to cast them out. Just like them scriptures said. And you're doubting. You said you think. Well, go ahead and repent of it. No, don't read any more books. Yeah, please, throw the books out. That's a trick of the devil. Well, in your head, that's not good enough. Now, you speak in tongues?
Yeah.
Okay, let's try it that. Oh, well, let's repent of it then. Go ahead. Good, very good. Louder. Atta girl. Let's start with the basics, okay? We're just going to start with the basics, okay? Your mind's all jacked up. Yeah, you're out of it. Okay, so you got to go to fix a broken mind. You got to go back to square one. Speaking in tongues. Can you sing in tongues? No, I didn't ask you if you could try to do it. I said, can you do it? Go ahead. Good girl. Louder. Good. Keep it going. And what's wrong with you, sweetheart?
I lost my hearing.
Yeah, when did that happen?
I think it was in like 1990.
And what was going on just before that? What was your life like before that?
Well, I was thinking I was dating this young man at church.
What's his name?
His name was Ron, and I felt like the Lord was telling me that I needed to let him go. Mm-hmm. And I brought that up to him, and he was, and I trusted him. He was, you know, a strong relationship with the Lord. And he goes, oh, I don't think so. And then, you know, while later, then I just woke up and I had some hearing loss.
Did you ever sleep with that guy? You never slept with him? Okay. What was his name?
Ron,
okay, ready? Close your eyes. Close your eyes there. Okay. Now, feel that anxiety that went right through you there when I did that and it was pushing on you. Do you feel that? You feel that anxiety you had when I was pushing you?
Oh, I could.
Do you feel the anxiety when I was pushing you?
Yeah.
Did you feel it in your body somewhere?
From the pushing, or
when I pushed you had anxiety. Notice that?
Yes.
Feel that?
Yes.
Feel that?
Yes.
That's a fear demon.
Okay.
Now, when did he get in there?
That.
When did he get in there? When did he get in there?
Fear?
The fear spirit. When you were a kid?
Yeah, I had some sexual abuse.
Somebody fondle you or something?
Yeah.
Who?
Strangers. One was a young man that my mom babysat, and another was an older man that took me into a restroom.
Gotcha. And you were how old?
Little.
5 or 6 or something?
Probably not.
Okay.
Sorry. With my hearing gone, my balance is off.
Okay. Now close your eyes and take a big breath and try to relax, okay? These are fear demons. They usually hide in this area right here, in the torso. Just relax. Breathe out of your mouth there. Thank you, Jesus. Breathe. Lord, I want you to go back in time here. Some perverts molested her when she was little, and they transferred in a spirit of fear into her body when she was little, and she's lived with this fear spirit her whole life. And he made her deaf in this ear. And he gave her anxiety. She's had it for years. He's hiding in there because two perverts took advantage of her. She was innocent. She did nothing wrong. And these spirits took advantage of her. They turned her into an anxiety disorder. And right now, Lord, I want you to hunt down those two guys or three guys, whoever it was. I want you to hunt them down. I want you to put your loving arms around them. I want you to tell them that we have forgiven them for what they did completely. And that tonight she has decided to exercise her authority in Christ and cast out these fear demons from these perverts. In Jesus' name, we forgive them and we release them from her soul. We forgive them and we release these men from her soul. And in addition to that, there have been other men who have mistreated her over the years. They used her money. They used her body. They made her promises they did not keep. They saw her as a dish rag or rug and stepped on her. I want you to hunt every single man down. Every one of them down. And let them know that we have forgiven them. In the name of Jesus, we're going to forgive them. All of them. All these bad, disappointing people. heartbreaking men. They disrespected her. They dishonored her. They tricked her into sinning with them. They talked her into adultery. Tonight, we are forgiving every single one of them. All of them. In the name of Jesus. Now, you pervert, you come out of that body and come out of her throat right now. Come on up. Come on up. She commands you to go. She binds your power, you spirit of lust and fear. You come out of her vagina and her womb. Come out of her tummy. She commands you to come up. She's using her authority in the name of Jesus and commanding you to come out of her body right now. Every ugly man that ever touched me emotionally, sexually, physically, every single one of them, you come out of my body right this second. You come out of my ears in the name of Jesus. Come out, you foul spirit, in the name of the Lord. You pervert, come out of me right this second. Come out right now. In Jesus' name, come out of me. Say that. I command you in the name of the Lord to come out of my body. This demonic equilibrium, it's fake. It's not real. You come out of my head. You get out of my body right now in Jesus' name. I command you, every lust demon that transferred into my body from being molested, I command it to come out in the name of Jesus right now. You get out. You speak in tongues. Go ahead. Oh, good. That's real good. Louder. Good. Louder. Good girl. Louder. Louder. Ouch. Good. Good, good. Louder. Louder. Loud. Add a girl like that. Yell it out. Come out, you pervert. Spirit, I command you to come on out. Come up. Ouch, girl. Get out of my body. Hello, Mashandra. Come out of that body right now. Out you go. Come on. Come on. Good girl. Louder. You get her for me. Get her for me. Go grab her, would you? Good. Hey, she's got transfer spirits. She got molested when she was little. You help her. She got molested by two different guys when she was about 5 or 6. Two guys molested her. She got fear spirits and anxiety. Thank you. Have you forgiven everybody? If you haven't, you're cooked. You are cooked. Have you forgiven everybody? If you haven't, you got a plague coming. You're in big trouble. Big trouble. When you don't forgive somebody, it brings in curses. Yeah, you got hard feelings against somebody? The Bible calls that ought. If you have ought against somebody, you got emotional problems with that person, uh-oh, guess who's in trouble? Not the person that did you wrong, you. You're in big trouble. Ought. Ought will kill you. Ought will destroy you. Who hurts you the worst? Who was it? Who hurts you the worst? Come on, we'll pray for that person. Love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who despitefully use you. Lord God, I pray for my abuser right now. I pray for the people that cheated me and lied to me. I pray for my boyfriend and my girlfriend that stabbed me in the back. I pray for every single person that hurt me. In Jesus' mighty name, I forgive them and I release this ought from my soul for that person. I don't like them. I don't feel comfortable with them. It's my ex-husband. I used to hate his guts. It's my ex-wife. I used to hate her guts. And I got ought against my ex. And that ought is killing me, not them. It'll kill you, not them. Just repent of it. Oh, Lord God, help me. Save me. I got ought. I got ought. I'm going to repent of it right now. All bad feelings, all negative emotions about that person, I'm going to release it in Jesus' mighty name right now. Come on. Just repent of it. Come on now. Repent of it. She's doing better. Notice that?
Yeah.
She's doing much better.
How can you tell?
I saw you. What's that thing?
This is a prayer that I wrote that we said over the campus, the U of A campus in Tucson.
Oh, really?
And so we were questioning whether it was a territorial spiritual warfare.
Were you praying for the people?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
great. But we
great.
Also bound the spirits of lust and addiction and depression.
Bad.
That's bad to do that?
Did it work?
I don't know.
They haven't come to us yet.
I pray over, I command all the lust demons of the U of A to leave. Come on now.
So it would have been fine if we said, Father, would you bind all the lust demons?
No, you're not going to do it. He's not going to bind all the lust demons.
So the only time we should what? Bind and loose is when we're with
personal.
Somebody one-on-one.
Yeah, personal.
In agreement with it.
Ideally, yeah. Yeah.
See, that's right. I've been praying for everything under the sun.
No, stop that. Why don't you pray for you?
I did. But it's only been like 2 weeks now.
No, good. Well, 2 weeks is better than nothing.
Well, I know.
Why not focus on you?
Everything. Scientology.
That's not going to do any good. Oh, it's a wasted prayer.
Okay. I get that I was wrong, but I didn't know how wrong.
Oh, you're wasting your prayers.
Well, not anymore. Not anymore.
The way I feel is like...
Did it work? Did you get Scientology? Are they crumbling? They're bigger than ever.
They will.
But basically we're praying for revival.
Right? Revival, great. Keep going. Yeah. That's a people prayer. Pray a people prayer. People prayer. Perfect.
Professors and over the students.
Pray for them, yeah. Pray for the professors and students, yeah.
And can we do
no binding and loosing.
It's not going to work.
But is it going to be harmful? Are we
they're going to come looking for you.
Understand where we went wrong because that's how I can repent of it.
You already understand it.
I can't repent if I can't. I might do it again if I don't understand what I did wrong the first
time. You understand it.
Okay.
You just said you did.
All right.
But everything you said was right.
Okay.
We just go out and do crap like that.
The best thing to do is do crap like this. Get this fixed. That's the best thing. Personal's the best.
I'll be back.
Lord, I pray you'll bless this Jones family over on Bellevue Avenue. And I pray you'll cast all the demons out of them. Okay, no. I pray they'll get saved. Bring them in, Lord. Touch them with love. Now you're on the right track. I command every demon to come out of their granddad. No, you can't. He wants to keep his demons. He's a pervert.
I was binding witchcraft in my spirit.
Over who?
Over the skull.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that. Now, if the witch, of course, if the witchcraft's coming right at you, now that's a different story. If somebody's trying to put spells on you, that's totally different, right? See that?
Because they thought I might have gotten hit with a witchcraft or curse in Africa.
Yeah, Africa's a dangerous place to go, you can even imagine. Never go over to Africa.
I lived there for 7 months.
Oh, no.
Oh. Sorry.
Oh. They've got demons over there we don't even have here. And to send somebody like that over there, they're going to get slaughtered.
Still standing.
Yeah. Mercy kept her standing. Okay. You don't send somebody with a pop gun into Iraq. You got to have real weapons.
How did you make it?
Hmm?
How did you fare?
I was only praying for the people and their demons. Directly there. I wasn't praying against witch doctors and
no, listen, I
just...
What
were you doing?
I was just a volunteer, just doing what they needed in the mission center.
Now that's risky. I wouldn't do it because a lot of witches and warlocks over there, they don't like Christian volunteers and they'll put curses on them. Risky. They come back sick. I've had them in my office. Particularly Jerusalem. That's the worst place to go.
Seriously?
Oh my God. No, because there are demons over there that nobody else has anywhere. The Catholics are there in mass. The Arabs are there. The Jews are there. The Orthodox Church is there. I mean, it's a cesspool of satanic activity. And people go over there and they come back with the Jerusalem syndrome. I've had them in my office. Sicker than dogs. They sleep in the hotels over there. You have no idea who's been in that hotel. They're all infested. Jerusalem's the worst place to go. Oh, extremely dangerous. Extremely dangerous. That's why. That's where they get infected. They go over in the church group. They get butchered. Oh, I didn't know you were going there for vacation. No, I wouldn't go there for any reason.
No, I mean other than Israel. I was making a time.
Yeah, why don't you go to Payson?
Go where?
Payson.
Payson?
That's where all the New Age is.
Payson?
You don't want to send anybody who's spiritually ignorant into a dangerous area. It's that simple. It's just common sense. How's it going? How'd you do? You look like you did great. What was wrong with you?
Really broken.
Over.
A man.
What did he do to you?
He's my boyfriend.
He betray you?
I don't know what happened. I'm confused.
He dumped you?
No.
You dumped him?
No.
You're still together?
Yeah.
Oh,
no.
Oh, good. Well, let's leave him there. What's his name?
Will.
Will. Okay, ready? Father, I want you to forgive this beautiful woman here. The demon sent her a plant. His name was Will. He was a plant. And he was sent there by the demons to deliberately hurt her and break her heart and transfer spirits into her body. There they are right there. Will, I command you to come out of that body right now. There he is. Will, we're releasing you permanently. Do not come back. Come out in Jesus' name. Come out. There he comes. Will, come out. Will, come out of that body right now. I release Will from my soul. I will never return to him. There he is. Keep coughing. Come out, devil. Every spirit that transferred into my body from Will, I renounce and reject. Come out of there, you user. Come out in Jesus' name. You told me you loved me, and you did not. You lied. There it is. Keep coughing. Come out, devil. Will, I command you to come out in Jesus' name. Come on. I let Will go right now. I'm releasing him. I'm going to wait for the man that God sends me, not the one the demons did. Go. Will, come out. Come out. There he is. Come on out. Keep going. Come on out of there quickly. Get out of there. I command every spirit from Will to come out of me right now. There he is. Every fear spirit he transferred into my body. All the chronic disappointment in my soul. All the sadness and fear of the future. I renounce it. Right now. I renounce it. All the fear of the future. Come on me now. Right now. Forgive me, Lord Jesus, for getting involved with Will. I should have gotten the okay from you, and I didn't. I went ahead using my own thoughts and my own emotions. I am so sorry, Lord Jesus. I let him go now. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Will, I release you to the Lord. Don't come back. Don't come back. Father has someone else for me. No more spirits. Come out. Will, no more fears. No more fear of the future. No more negative thoughts in my mind. There he is. Oh, that's him right there. Come out of your brain right now. Come on out. Lift. 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 Peace come in. Peace come in. Sweet Holy Spirit, heal. Heal her soul from Will's abuse. Holy Spirit, come. Heal her soul. Heal her soul. Heal my soul, Lord. Please heal me. Heal my soul, dear Lord. I will release Will right now and let him go. I'll wait for you and your choice for me. In the name of Jesus, I will wait for you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I love you, dear Lord. Okay, ready? Go. Tell him I love him. Tell him you love him. Thank you, Jesus. Tell him. Come on. What's going on over here? Who are these people? Your parents? These your parents? Wow. What's wrong with him? What's wrong with you?
Freedom from the spirit of condemnation, lust, anxiety, depression.
Used to be on drugs? No drugs? No pot? No. Alcohol? No. Oh, were you abused as a kid?
No.
When did all this start? What happened?
One thing I can remember is, you know what OCD is, right?
Yeah.
It came over me just in an instant.
Where were you when it happened?
I was at home in my room. I was trying to put a toy in my nightstand drawer.
Mm-hmm.
And I had this OCD to just, like, I didn't close it enough. And it just told me I was, like, crying. I came to my parents.
Oh. Now, is your parents Catholics?
Well, my dad used to be, but my heart is...
He used to be a Catholic. How about mom?
No.
What religion are they?
Christian.
What church they go to?
We attend about a couple... It's a little bit weird, but Baptist primarily.
You're in Baptist church? All right. Are you born again? How do you know that?
When I was 4 or 3 years old, I was with my mom at the lunch table.
You were three? You say you were three?
I thought it was four. She wrote down the date. Apparently, I was three. But
then what happened?
My mom was sharing the gospel with me, and as far as I remember, God just opened my heart to accept Christ and childlike faith. So that's what I remember.
And then anything change after that?
I would say that probably around, I can't remember exactly, but maybe around 10 or when I was becoming a teenager, I started to become more sinful and have doubts and stuff like that. And probably,
how long has your mom been suffering from depression?
My mom?
Yeah.
Has been somewhat depressed pertaining to some things going on with one of my sisters.
Older or younger?
Younger, I would say it probably goes back 10 or more years.
What'd your daughter do?
Well, right, more recently she ran away for the second time, but before that she says she's been abused by us, and she calls us all kinds of really bad things.
Well, from what age did she start doing that?
I would say started about 12.
12?
She's 20 right now.
And their depression started when?
I don't even remember.
It's been a while. It's just, it grows and just compiles, and we can see it in her.
Hey, will you go get me two of those miracle lists? Yeah, well, what's happening here is the demons just swept through the family and took everybody. It's a clean sweep.
There's more to it. I don't know.
More bad to it.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm about to say, but another one of my sisters, also younger, was molested by arguably my best friend. So there's just a lot of stuff.
It was just you and your sister?
We have three girls.
Three girls.
I have one older.
All right. Hey, listen. Yeah. This list is the only hope you got. Will you start going over that and then give me a call and come in for a counseling appointment? And the situation is really bad spiritually. And then you give me a call. You go, hey, look, will you go get one of my cards? Thanks.
Mikey and I spoke about 2 weeks ago. I called and even left a couple messages.
Oh, what's your name again?
Craig.
Okay.
Do we all three come at the same time?
Probably come individually first and then come as a group, if that's okay. You go.
Would it be like in one day, like 1, 2, 3, and then together?
We live far away.
Oh, where do you live at?
Whitman.
Oh, no, we should do it all in one day then, since you live in Whitman. That's at the hike. Mm-hmm. Yeah, remind me who you are, okay? Yeah, this is...
We're the Maloof family.
Maloof, okay, I use Maloof, okay. Yeah, the spirits got into his brain and your daughter's brain. They're hijacking their mind. And the longer this goes, the sicker they're going to get. And the demons know you came here tonight. They know you came here. So we got to move hard, quickly. All right? Yeah, can you stand up here for a minute so I can pray for you? What's your name?
Danette,
huh? Okay. All right. Thank you, Jesus. Close your eyes there. Just take a big breath. Big breath. Close your eyes. Lord Jesus. Wow. I feel hurt tonight. This loving woman has had so much stress and so many burdens on her soul. I can't even imagine it. She needs inner healing. I'm asking you, Lord, to help her. All these disappointments, all these fears, all the fears of her children, all the heartache from childhood, it's all stacking up now, wearing her out. I know you've cried over in the past, watching her suffer. Sometimes she suffers quietly. Nobody knows it. You know it, Lord. You understand. Sweet Holy Spirit, it's time that your best girl gets healed. I know you think about her all the time. I know you've been hurt watching her in agony. It hides in there, in the soul. Holy Spirit, heal. Mercy, Lord. Touch this body, Lord. Heal it. Holy Spirit, come in. Take a big breath. Holy Ghost, move. Breathe in. Holy Spirit, come. And breathe. Heal. Breathe and heal, Lord. You demon of oppression, I bind your power. You let go of this woman of God. You spirit of heaviness, let go of her. Breathe. Holy Spirit, heal now. Mercy, Lord. I ask you to forgive her children for what they have done to her. I ask you to forgive her children for what they've done to her, especially her daughter. All the word curses she put on her. All the negative statements that were lies. Her demons spout off lies about the mother. Heal, Lord. Forgive her daughter for what she's done. Heal. Have mercy, Lord. I ask you to release any guilt and shame she has in her soul right now. Shame over not being the kind of mother she thought she should be. Her daughter explained to her that she was a lousy mother. And her daughter verbally abused her, and that pain went right there into her soul. There it is. Let your tears go. Come on now. The Holy Ghost touching you right now. There it is right now. He's touching you right now, sweetheart. There he is. Thank you, sweet Lord Jesus, the blood Lord Jesus, the blood. Let your tears go. Tonight, I release my daughter into the hands of the Lord. I let my daughter go right now. There we go. Let your tears go. Come on, sweetheart. There you go. Let them go. All these disappointments, all these heartaches, out they go. There it is. Let your tears go, honey. The Holy Ghost is going to heal you right now. He's right here. He's staring right at you. He's staring right at you. He come right here for you. Oh, he wants to help you. Thank you, Jesus. All these wounds, these nasty curse words her daughter spoke that cut her into her soul right there. Come out. Come out. Come out right now. Dad, let her go. All this satanic evil. Loose this woman of God in Jesus' mighty name. Come out of there right now. All the betrayal, all these disappointments, out into Jesus' holy name. I give my daughter to you, Lord. I hand her to you, lock, stock, and barrel. Every bit of her. Go. Go. No more shame, no more guilt. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Big breath. Holy Spirit, come in. Atta girl. Breathe again. Heal. There we go. Good girl. Holy Spirit, come. Thank you, Jesus. All the stress, all the worry, all the fear of the future for her kids, out now. Out now in Jesus' holy name. I give it to you, Lord. I'm going to nail this to the cross right now. Bang. I give it to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, dear Lord. I let my daughter go and I won't pick her back up. She's in your hands now, Lord. I can't heal her. I can't help her. You must do it. You have to do it. Not me. So I give her to you of my own free will. I let my baby go now. I place her in your loving hands. And all the stress comes off of me. Off. Off. In the name of the Lord. By faith, I let my daughter go to you, Jesus. I need a miracle. And Brother Mike and me, we don't have any miracles. We need a miracle. Peace be still. Phew. Thank you, Jesus. I love you. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Tell him you love him now. Go ahead. I love you, Jesus. Tell him. He knows you do, but he wants to hear it. He likes to hear you say it, just like you wanted to hear it from your kids. Thank you, Jesus. You don't get that from your daughter anymore, but you will later when the miracle comes. I love you, Jesus. Good girl. Tell him you love him now. Come on. Come on, sweetheart. Go ahead. YouTubers, what an interesting night tonight was. Spiritual warfare, binding and loosing. Deo Luo. Go to the website, hardcorechristianity.com, hit the teaching button and read those two articles, How Satan Controls the Mind and Satan's Counterattack. You will be hit within 48 hours of this service. The devil's going to try to steal everything you've learned and every spirit that left you. He's going to try and replace it with another one. Don't forget about our Monday night Zoom for the ladies. Don't forget about our Wednesday night Zoom for everybody. And tomorrow, 6 o'clock tomorrow night, the healing service. Man, you got to be here to see this. It's going to be spectacular. And I will see you next time.